Another important tip towards testability is about how classes handle their dependencies. One traditional way of programming, and we actually did this in our very first invoice filter implementation, was that if a class has a dependency, it then just instantiates these dependencies and uses them. And in our invoice filter, the very first code was nil invoice data access object and then use it. But we saw that this approach wasn't very good from the testability perspective, because we were then not able to replace this object by a mock, which we wanted to. So the solution was to make these dependencies kind of explicit and receive them via constructor. This allowed us, in other words, to inject the dependencies. And the benefits were that we could then mock. There is a very nice analogy about it. Suppose that you need a hammer to do a task. The common approach is you look for the hammer, you get the hammer, and you use the hammer. But we can do it differently. So if I need a hammer, I tell people, hey, I can work, but I need a hammer. Then whenever someone needs me, this person needs to give me the hammer so that I can do my job. And this is what we are doing here. So the invoice filter needs a hammer, or it needs a data access object class to work. And someone needs to inject or pass this class to the invoice filter. This idea of making the dependencies more explicit and receiving them via constructor is what we call dependency injection. And advantages are many. First one, that now I know that the dependencies of my class because I have to pass them via constructor. It makes the design of this class explicit. The second is then I can inject whatever implementation I want, and this means in the test I can pass mocks to these classes. Third, because it makes this class more extensible. If in the future I'll need to change the way invoice data access object works, I can simply replace that class by injecting a new one, and I don't even have to change the invoice filter. This extensibility is actually called the open-close principle, which I'm not gonna discuss deeply in here, but I'm gonna leave it as a reading for you at the end of the course. So make sure that we can always inject the dependencies of a class. This will help you a lot when it comes to write automated tests.